Did you know that every time you buy a light bulb, you're essentially giving thanks to the British Industrial Revolution? Light bulbs come in various capacities like 30 watt, 60 watt, and so forth. These watts indicate the power consumed per second. But where does the term watt come from? It's named after James Watt, the inventor who played a pivotal role in the Industrial Revolution with his steam engine. To honor Watt's contributions, the British Science Association named the unit of power after him, and many countries adopted it, expressing gratitude collectively. However, if we delve deeper, Watt wasn't the original possessor of the steam engine's foundational technology. The credit goes to Denis Papin, a French physicist. If the Industrial Revolution had started in France instead of Britain, perhaps we'd be thanking Papin instead of Watt. But history didn't unfold that way. Following our exploration into why the Industrial Revolution began in Britain first, Part 2 will discuss why other countries lagged behind. We will also lightly touch upon whether people who lived through the Industrial Revolution were genuinely happier than before. While considering various countries, we will focus more on France, as it was a leading contender, and briefly introduce the essentials from other nations. It wouldn't have been strange if France, not Britain, had been the pioneer of the Industrial Revolution. France, an agricultural powerhouse, had a significantly larger economy compared to Britain at the time. By the end of the 18th century, France's GDP and population were three times larger than Britain's. In terms of technology and scientific advancement, France was not inferior to Britain. Between the 1760s and 1840s, when Britain was deeply immersed in the Industrial Revolution, France was home to monumental figures like Antoine Lavoisier, the father of modern chemistry, Pierre-Simon Laplace, a mathematician famed for the Laplace transform, and André-Marie Ampère, who laid the foundations of electrical science. The unit of electric current, the ampere, is named after Ampère. These notable individuals alone give us a glimpse into the advanced scientific standing of France at the time. If there was an area where France was lacking compared to Britain during the Industrial Revolution, it would be the reserves of essential resources like coal and iron. The banking system in France, necessary for financing factory constructions, was also less developed compared to Britain. France had fewer colonies to sell goods to as well. However, these differences weren't vast. France, too, had enough coal and iron to sustain the scale of the Industrial Revolution. And their banking sector wasn't far behind, as all were in the early stages of capitalism. France might not have had as many colonies as Britain, but they were not far behind. So, what made the difference? The fundamental reason why the Industrial Revolution in France lagged behind Britain was the exceedingly conservative social and political atmosphere at the time, referred to specifically as the Ancien Régime. In simple terms, the Ancien Régime represented a resistance to change, an attitude of not wanting anything to transform. In fact, since the early 1600s, France believed itself to be a country without significant issues. While Britain was embroiled in chaos due to the aristocrats' triumph over the conflict between monarchy and clergy, France built a strong, centralized state under the overpowering rule of King Louis XIV, the Sun King. Thanks to the mercantilist policies of Chief Minister Cardinal Richelieu during the previous reign, France essentially became the most potent power in Europe during the Sun King's era. The prestige of France was so high that mastery of the French language was considered essential for European nobles. This immense pride hindered France from feeling the need for reform or innovation. Religious intolerance was another persisting issue in France. Being the most significant Catholic country in Europe, France had already perpetrated mass slaughters against Protestants in the 16th century, known as the Huguenot Wars. The majority of French Catholics were illiterate peasants, while the Protestants were knowledgeable enough to read the Bible, which had become widely available due to the advent of the printing press. Those who could no longer live in France due to various conditions crossed over to Switzerland, the Netherlands, and Britain, becoming key figures in the Industrial Revolution in these countries. France lost many talented individuals due to religious conflicts, one of whom was Denis Papin. Papin, a Protestant, fled to Britain where he patented an invention related to a steam digester, a precursor to the modern pressure cooker. He later even constructed a steamboat. While serving as a professor in a German university, he was about to conduct a trial voyage of his steamboat on the River Elbe, when boatmen, fearing the loss of their livelihoods, destroyed his boat by setting it on fire. Unfortunately, his research ended up being buried there, but thanks to Papin's technology involving steam, British scientists could advance steam engines, eventually leading to the practical steam engine by Watt, which became a decisive catalyst in the British Industrial Revolution. On the other hand, Britain, having faced chaos due to the victory of the aristocrats, closely approached capitalism by securing private property and patent rights through events like the Glorious Revolution. In contrast, France, struggling under the Ancien Régime, remained stuck in absolutism, opposing capitalism, and ignoring the significant global changes, leading to internal contradictions piling up. Dismantling nearly 200 years of accumulated old regimes wasn't just accomplished through the French Revolution. They had to go through destructive processes like the Napoleonic Wars and revolutions in July and February. Due to these prolonged political instabilities, France's Industrial Revolution was delayed by more than 50 years compared to Britain. Although they left the Eiffel Tower as a monument from this era, due to these influences, France ended up in a military disadvantage against Germany, suffering defeats in both World War I and II. Today, Germany stands as the most industrially advanced country in Europe. However, their Industrial Revolution lagged over 20 years behind even that of France. While the Industrial Revolution ignited in Britain, Germany was still entrenched in the Middle Ages, fragmented into numerous small feudal lordships around the hollow entity known as the Holy Roman Empire. These factions were too preoccupied with internal conflicts to spare any effort towards an industrial revolution. Germany stepped into the arena of industrial transformation around the mid to late 19th century, amidst the unification of Germany spearheaded by Prussia. A unique aspect of Germany's industrial surge was that it was nationally driven, centralized around the vigorous protectionist policies of the Iron Chancellor Bismarck. During this period, Germany established a distinctive vocational school tradition focused on science and technology education. Although late to the Industrial Revolution, Germany managed to catch up to a century's worth of Britain's progress in merely 50 years. Spain, at that time, was undoubtedly a powerhouse in Europe. There was a time when Spain ruled territories more expansive than even Rome. However, their Achilles' heel proved to be religious fanaticism. As a reaction to a long period of Islamic rule, Spanish Catholicism became extremely conservative soon after the Reconquista. Spain is infamously known for its brutal witch hunts. What significantly undermined Spain was the mass expulsion of Jews for religious reasons, which ended up draining the nation of financial experts. Concurrently, gold and silver plundered from the American colonies began pouring into Spain. Instead of capitalizing economically on this tremendous influx of wealth, the absence of financial experts led to catastrophic inflation. Additionally, in a bid to defend Catholicism, vast amounts of gold and silver were squandered in wars across Europe, leading to Spain's downfall as a dominant European power. Portugal, who once spearheaded the Age of Discovery and dominated Europe, trod a path similar to Spain. Blinded by the influx of gold and silver from the Americas, they became complacent, failing to recognize or feel the necessity for innovation and progression. The Netherlands was also an undeniable powerhouse in Europe at the time. After gaining independence from Spain, the Netherlands, lacking suitable conditions for agriculture, amassed wealth early on through maritime trade. However, this small country consistently relied on military force in its trading methods, eventually losing ground in competition with France and Britain. A significant reason for their decline was the considerable trade in luxury goods, which took a direct hit when climate change led to the collapse of agriculture across Europe. The Netherlands, despite being a catalyst for monumental changes like the Industrial Revolution, was realistically too small, encountering visible limitations. Did people living through the Industrial Revolution experience a better life than before? Unfortunately, that wasn't the case. A study even suggests that people during the Industrial Revolution in Britain endured some of the hardest living conditions in the nation's history. Urbanization surged, ushering in a multitude of problems. Coal was heavily consumed in factories and homes, normalizing the notorious London smog. Statistics from 1851 to 1910 reveal that air pollution caused as many as 4 million tuberculosis deaths. The Thames River in London became polluted due to insufficient sanitation facilities, leading to regular outbreaks of typhoid and cholera, with no available death tolls. An influx of urban workers caused wages to plummet, forcing even children into labor to supplement family incomes. Children worked up to 15 hours a day in factories, barely earning enough for a meal. A significant increase in urban crime was another major issue. Most crimes were petty, like stealing a few pieces of bread out of sheer hunger. But due to a lack of detention facilities, even these minor criminals were often sentenced to death. Amid growing criticism, these minor offenders were exiled overseas, a practice that contributed to the settlement of Australia. Britain only began to truly benefit from the Industrial Revolution over 100 years later, in the late 19th century, when British imperialism firmly entrenched its dominance over the colonies, improving the lives of Britons. However, for non-European nations, it opened the gates to a tragic era of oppression. The outcomes of the Industrial Revolution are relatively clear. Countries that embraced the revolution, albeit later, typically rose to empire status like Russia and Japan. In contrast, those that didn't, including traditional powerhouses like the Ottoman Empire, India, and China, either fell into decline or endured the hardships of colonization. Now, we stand on the brink of the Fourth Industrial Revolution, an inevitable occurrence. With each revolution, the reins of power shift among nations.
Which country will emerge powerful next?